Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. In this short video, we're going to be looking at how to deal with a fuel imbalance. This is a procedure that can be performed on the ground as well as in the air. So before we jump in, don't forget to hit the thumbs up and give the video a like. So let's dive into our lower ECAM fuel page, and you'll see we have slight imbalance between the right and the left tanks. Now, before we do anything here, it's important to establish whether or not we have a fuel leak. So we must compare the fuel on board, which is up here on the upper ECAM, to the fuel used on the lower ECAM, and compare that with the fuel on board at departure. If the difference is significant, or if the fuel on board plus the fuel used decreases, we should suspect a fuel leak. And then we follow a whole process of trying to establish where that fuel leak is, and I'll cover that in a different video. It's important to remember, a word of caution, a fuel imbalance may indicate a fuel leak, and do not apply this procedure if a fuel leak is suspected. It's also worth noting that there's no requirement to correct an imbalance until the ECAM fuel advisory is displayed. There are certain permissible amounts of imbalance, and that varies depending on the amount of fuel in one wing compared to the other, and can also vary at different flight stages. Rather than talk all of those through, I'll put them into a document and post that into the channel Discord document section. So once we've established there's no fuel leak, how do we correct that imbalance? Now, the process is quite straightforward. So at the moment we've got all our fuel pumps on, the fuel crossfeed valve here is closed. The first thing we do is open the fuel crossfeed. So we come up to the overhead, through the fuel panel here, and there's our crossfeed valve. We open that, and you see the valve transitions, and the fuel line is now opened up, connecting both wing tank supplies. We then want to turn off the center tanks. Left and right center tanks off, and you see the valves have transitioned there. And the next thing we want to do is turn off the pumps on the lighter side. So fuel pumps on the lighter side, so it's important to verify that we're turning the correct ones off. So our left port side wing is the lighter tank. So we come up and we turn left tank pumps confirmed 1 and 2 off. Check the ECAM again. Those pumps have turned off. And now we're in a position where the right tank is supplying both engines. And subsequently that weight will be corrected. It takes a little bit of time. Now this is a process we want to monitor closely. We don't want to get distracted, so we need to make sure we're doing this in a stage of flight where we can give this our attention, as you could make what was a slight imbalance a much larger problem. So slowly the weight on the right will come down. So if we pretend for the sake of the video that both tanks are now balanced, the procedure is now to turn on all the fuel pumps and then turn the crossfeed off. So we come back to the overhead. Fuel pumps on. Confirmed. We always confirm that on the lower ECAM. Then we close the crossfeed. Crossfeed closed. And that's the process completed. That is how we'll do with an imbalance. The word of caution there, check for fuel leaks. So comparing our fuel information and establishing first if that is the issue. Imbalances do occur. Obviously the APU is fed from the left tank, so that's the usual suspect for creating a fuel imbalance. Also single engine taxi, and sometimes during cruise when you've got a very strong crosswind and the aircraft corrects for that with a bit of extra thrust on one side, that can also cause an imbalance. So a number of different ways an imbalance can occur, but the procedure for dealing with it is the same whether that's on the ground or in the air. If you have any questions on that at all, please drop them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer those. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.